Hi, I'm teacher Mazuin. Do you still remember the Pascal triangle that you learned in the chapter 1, pattern and sequence in form 2? Okay, the Pascal triangle invented by a French mathematician Blaise Pascal has a lot of unique properties. So, in this video, we are going to explore more about Pascal triangle and learn how to construct a Pascal triangle, and then we will learn one or two basic properties of Pascal triangle. Okay, let us learn how to construct a Pascal triangle. Okay, this is Pascal triangle. Okay, the first element of each row is actually called row 0. Okay, row 0. Okay, so as you can see, each row in the Pascal triangle start with row 0. Okay, so this is the element of row 0. This is element of the first row, second row, and so on. The top is actually element of 0 row. Okay, this is the element of first row, second row, first row, second row. Okay, the first at the top one is the row 0, and the below is row 1, row 2, row 3, and so on. Okay, each row start with zero elements, and zero element on each row is actually each row is equal to one. Okay, you see the row, each row F1 number 1. Okay, right? How we construct the Pascal triangle is, in each element in the Pascal triangle is actually the sum of two elements. Okay, which are resting above this. Okay, you see this 1 plus 1, you get 2. Okay, so if we talk about this 10, okay, number 10, this number 10 is nothing but sum of the 4 plus 6 will become 10. Okay, so next, if number 5 also, number 15 also is nothing without active. Okay? So this is how we construct Pascal triangle. Okay? How we construct the Pascal triangle. And this is how we refer the each element in the Pascal triangle. After this, we are going to discuss the properties of Pascal triangle. So this is rho 0, and then this rho is rho 1, rho 2, rho 3, rho 4, rho 5, rho 6, rho 7, rho 8, rho 9, and the last one is rho 10. Okay? So this is the properties is actually sum of each element in the each row. Okay, so if we talk about the row 0, this the top one, sum of the element is actually 1 plus 0 will give us 1. Okay? So in the first row will this 1 plus 1 we will get 2. And then the second row is 1 plus 2 plus 1, we will get 4. Okay, you can continue to calculate the at each element by row until the last row. You will get the answer at the last. You will get the sum of the each row. Okay.
Okay, let's try to do this activity. So this activity we'll do in individual. So what you should do is construct the Pascal triangle as in set 1, and then calculate the sum of the numbers in each row. After that, write the sum in index form with base of 2. So, complete set 1A with index form with base of 2 without using calculator. So, you can fill your answer in the table at set 1A. After that, we will discuss the answer together. So, you may start do your activity. Alright, did you finish the activity that we did before? So this is the answer. Yeah, this is the sum of the each row, and then the sum in the index form with base 2. So how we get the answer is, for as we know, one at the top is known as row 0. So how to get the answer is 1 plus 0 we will get 1, and then 1 plus 2 we will get 2, 1 plus 2 was plus 1 we will get 4. So you can calculate all the answer row by row until the last row is 11, row 11. So this is the answer. 0 row you get 1, first row you get 2, second row you get 4, third row you get 8, and next you get 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512, and then the last one you get 1024. So this is all the answer. Okay, next we move to the next column is index form. So in this question, you must sum in index form with base 2. So the base is 2. All the base is 2. So how to get the index is, you see the triangle. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is the index number. Okay. For example, at the top one, if we know the row at the top is row 0, so the index is 0. And then row 1, the below one, you know as a row 1, so the index is 1, and then you can continue until the last row is index 10. Okay, the end. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoy the activity in this video, and thank you.